What's going on, guys? It's JM, it's Speakboxing. Make sure you guys subscribe to this channel before you click onto any of my videos. Also, comment below in the comment section if you guys have any opinions in what I'm saying in any of my videos. Like always, it is appreciated if you guys could drop me a quick sub or two on my channel. So, Dillian Whyte recently did an interview on IFL TV. It's about 45 minutes long. It's a very interesting interview by Dillian Whyte, just talking about his future plans, talking about fighters like Deontay Wilder and Joseph Parker, saying that he's closing in on a world title shot against one of them guys, about him pulling out of the fight against Marius Wack that was meant to happen last Saturday night. And he talks about the Derek Chisora situation as well, because Dillian Whyte pulled out of the Marius Wack fight with a back injury, and then Derek Chisora pulled out of his fight against Robert Hellenius that was meant to happen on May 27th. And Dillian Whyte says that he agreed to fight Derek Chisora on July the 1st of this year. So I'm guessing my suspicions were right about that fight, because I thought when both fighters pulled out of the fight, I thought these fighters are pulled out of this fight to fight each other. Obviously, it's more money, it's more lucrative, these two are going to fight each other. And according to Dillian Whyte, he was going to fight Derek Chisora on July the 1st, but they couldn't come to terms on Derek Chisora's side. They couldn't agree to terms. He said that he agreed, he said he was ready to fight Derek Chisora in a rematch, because the first fight was a fantastic fight. Both guys just going at it for 12 rounds. Dillian Whyte managed to squeak a 12 round split decision against Derek Chisora. A lot of people thought Derek Chisora won the fight. I thought that Derek Chisora nicked it by a round or two, but just the animosity from the first fight and the hype, obviously we all know the gloves are off situation when bottles were being thrown, and fucking Dillian Whyte had to be restrained by about 10 security guards. And at the press conference when Derek Chisora flung the table at Dillian Whyte and his team. So that fight paid a big deal to Anthony Joshua's pay-per-view fight with Eric Molina, because at the end of the day, we all knew that Anthony Joshua and Eric Molina was going to be a mismatch, just by Eric Molina's demeanour and fucking just how limited Eric Molina is as a fighter. Oh, don't get me wrong, Eric Molina is a heavyweight who could bang and stuff like that, but as an all-round fighter, he's very limited, and I just knew Anthony Joshua was going to take him out. And I think that fight really did contribute to that pay-per-view doing well. I think it did about 500,000 buys, and I think that contributed at least 150,000 buys to that fight, well, to that pay-per-view, because there was just so much animosity between Derek Chisora and Dillian Whyte, and people do want to see a rematch because they felt that Derek Chisora won, that Dillian Whyte got a gift decision. So I think Dillian Whyte should fight Derek Chisora again before going in for a world title shot. Don't get me wrong, if a world title shot comes for Dillian Whyte first, then he's obviously going to take it, because he wants his shot at the heavyweight title, Dillian Whyte. But I think if he can get a fight made with Derek Chisora, even though they couldn't come to terms for the July 1st fight, maybe they can come to terms for later this year. Maybe it could be on the undercard of Anthony Joshua, Vladimir Klitschko too, because Anthony Joshua has to face Vladimir Klitschko by December the 2nd. He's just got his IBF exemption. I've explained that on another video. So maybe if Anthony Joshua fights Vladimir Klitschko again, which it looks like he is going to do, then maybe you put Dillian Whyte and Derek Chisora on the undercard, and we have a fantastic rematch between them two guys, because the first fight was fantastic. Both guys were hurt. Both guys were landing massive bombs in the fight. Dillian Whyte in particular was out on his feet in some of them rounds, and Derek Chisora was hurt as well. But we all know Derek Chisora has a fantastic chin, but so is Dillian Whyte. But Dillian Whyte was more noticeably hurt in that fight than Derek Chisora. So it was interesting how Dillian Whyte got the split decision, and I think that's a good fight for both guys. I think both guys will make a lot of money. And yeah, comment below in the comment section, what do you guys think it is? It's